How is everybody today? Morning, afternoon, day. Hope today finds you well. Nice, bright, sunny day today. Today is Thursday. It is kind of strange that they are all melding into each other. And just currently writing, typing. I'm open and ready to see mind how you feed your mind. Let's get it on. Keep on keeping on. So now, Le Peeps, how are you? Thanks for coming in today. Hey, Frankie. Hey, Natasha. Thanks for joining us. Me, us, what, whatever. We're all here today. So lovely, bright, sunny day. May it last for quite a while. Maybe I'll be able to get outside for a short while and get a bit of walking in and stuff like that. So, okay, yeah, technically we're near the weekend, and I don't think a thing like that matters currently because it's nearly all the weekend or not, depending on how your day goes and how you, Frankie. So I just want to say thanks again for joining in. And we should do some Reiki and some drumming and some Reiki. And hey, Chris, thanks for joining in. And Richie, how are you? Thanks for joining in. So we're going to do some Reiki, and with the Reiki, we will invest in ourselves as per usual. We will always start our days off in, yeah, in your own time as well, of course. I mean, but with this meditation, I certainly ask that we or suggest that we invest in ourselves first, and with that, then we can, if needs be, help others. Because as I've often said, you cannot pour from an empty cup. So we fill ourselves up first, and if people need and want us and stuff like that, with meditation and we. Hey Ash, how's it going? We're able to give. So through meditation, through sitting with ourselves, through sitting in silence, through filling our own cup, okay, we enable ourselves to be available for others. But first and foremost, we do need to be available to ourselves. That's a nearly a given. Okay, some people don't know that. That's fair enough. That's okay. But here we are now. And with that, I shall light a candle for us to use as our guiding light for the day ahead of us. And hey Dave, how are you? So this light is for us to bring inside our hearts and to use as our guidance for the day. And be aware of, like, one of the it's up here on my screen. It's on my top right. I don't know where it is on your screen, but one of my phrases is mind how you feed your mind, because we are all aware of what's going on. We know that. That's grand, all good. It's how we deal with that. We need to prevent ourselves going down rabbit holes and, like, dive bombing into scenarios where we can't get back out. So this is an ask, but it's still an important thing. Don't worry, be happy. So mind yourselves, and that mind yourselves in scenarios where you feel you're going to a place where it's not very well lit. Some words I'm not using good enough. So we need to find our own light and use this light that we've given ourselves, and we'll give ourselves more light as well. Use this light to show us our way. Okay, so now I'm going to light some. Burn some sage to help us with that. And if you find yourselves even Chris has just written that meditation. When you're meditating, if you can, give yourselves even a minute. Seriously, like meditation doesn't necessarily mean 20 minutes, half an hour to an hour. It doesn't. It means, oh yeah, my understanding of it, of course, which I've learned off many people who I trust and love, or love and trust, whichever way, is if you can even just switch off for a minute, that's enough. That's a start. And it's so this is for you. This is for me. This is for our ancestors. And this is for those behind us, minding us. This is those ahead of us, minding us. I'm going to call in my ancestors. And there's a few people who have recently headed off into the great yonder, recently, who I'm going to call upon to help us as well. Help me anyway, certainly, and I would like to share their energy. And you, if you care to do so, can call upon your ancestors to help us get through this. And frozen again, am I? Okay, well, I'm Grant here, so this might be here. Hang on, no, okay, I'm okay here. Sugar. Anyway, I'm gonna keep going. Yeah, I see that now. Okay, I'm a bit right. So sorry about that little interlude there. My network is getting a bit overloaded. Probably all these people watching me. Yes. Anyway, so we're gonna call upon our ancestors. We're gonna call upon our higher selves, and we're thanks. And we're going to call upon our higher selves, which are our future selves. We're going to call upon our ancestors, and we are going to. Thanks, Stephen. Appreciate that. We're going to call upon our inner selves, our inner child. We're going to call upon our inner child today. Now, here we are. We're going to nurture our inner child, our little baby, the person who brought us here. Okay, the person who allowed us to be here. And yeah, I love my inner child. I love me too. And I know you all love yourself. That's the important part. Okay, so without for oh yeah, well, actually, I was going to say something. Now I'm not. Now we're going to smile for 15 seconds. Okay. So we're going to release our serotonin. So after three, join with me in a big smiley. Okay, for 15 seconds. One, two, three. Yeah, big smiley chops off everyone there. Orla, thanks for joining in. Thanks very much, Chris. So there's the smile, there's our serotonin, there's our feel-good chemical that we have just made for ourselves, and we can do this every day. And if you see a reflective surface anywhere today, blow yourself a kiss. You deserve it. I do it every day, and I love it. Okay, there you go. So now I'm going to bell us in. Seven bells, seven chakras. And then I'm going to head off and do some Reiki with permission and respect. And there you are. Okay, so see you in a few minutes, okay? Yeah, just bring ourselves back and we close one hand over the other. And we let the light grow in our hands, let the energy grow and glow. And as it gets a little more brighter, we use this light in our hands that we have made ourselves. We place it on our inner chest, in our hearts. And we use this light to bring us about. To bring us about our day, to help us with our day, and to keep us buoyant, to keep us keep our head above water, and to allow ourselves to be bright. This is the thing, we need to allow ourselves, and we need to, I'm gonna, I will go into this in a minute, but just keep the light in your chest. A couple of breaths, bring it in. Hold that light there, and anything else, just let it go. Let the energy go where it needs to go. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, have a little stretch. Yawn. Bring ourselves down, and I'll close this session, this current session. Hey, John. Hey, whoops, a daisy. Hey, Dave. Hey, John. So just close this session. You have seven bells, one for each chakra. Now that's just grounded for the moment. I'm going to do some drumming. I'm actually going to call in a friend of mine and see if she's okay. Let's see if she's okay. So now we're going to do some drumming, but first we are going to do some reading. I'm going to read off this book here, The Medicine Woman Inner Guidebook by Carol Bridges. And my favorite bunch of cards. I have a few. So today's guidance, today's read, today's information that we might need for us, certainly for me, anyway, this works for me. And of course, with any reading, any card reading you may ever encounter, go with what resonates with you. Don't try and make it fit. So far, so good, these do. That's, you know, whatever, that's cool too. And it doesn't resonate with you, that's cool. It's all right. So today's card is ecstasy. Okay, so that's a interesting scenario there. The lover's ecstasy, number six. I know, obviously there's a lot of read here, which I'm not going to go into. We don't, yeah, there's too many pages there. Anyway, so number and meaning. Six, beauty, equilibrium. Traditional name, lovers. Medicine woman energy, the lovers, finding the spirit within, unite with ecstasy. Affirmation. With love, I entice the inner person into relationship with the outer world. I attract what I wish to become and I radiate what I am. Beauty surrounds me. The earth and I are one. Gonna see. Okay, so meditation. Visit the lovers within yourself, the ones who have attained that perfect union for which you long. Ask for their guidance in your own love relationship. What is it you need to know in order to be more blissfully together? How can you harmonize the opposites within yourself? Listen to what they tell you. Now, this is for self-love. Okay, it's a thing that not a lot of people are well experienced in because of society, because the way some people treat you, because the way you may have learned to treat yourself in certain scenarios through experience, and usually that's other people's experience shooting you down. Okay, so what I suggest, if I may, is that you again love yourself, because going back to the cup, you cannot pour from an empty cup. So seriously, this is an exercise I suggest you do. It took me a while, and you know, I love it anyway, but in your bathroom, in your hall, wherever, if you're, you know, find a place on your own, if you have a little compact mirror, or whatever it is, a shiny little thing, you know, a reflective surface, I would suggest that you sit with yourself and you call upon yourself, your inner self, and you look at yourself and you blow yourself a kiss and you say, I love you. Okay. How you react to that, I don't know. That's an individual experience. But I will say that as you practice that, I know you get lighter and brighter, and a lot of stuff will be lifted out of you. And self-love is the key to a lot of things. Okay, and there you go. Like I'm personally speaking, I am quite the proponent of self-love. And it took a while. It takes learning. It takes skill. It takes asking people questions. It takes, you know, going to teachers. So it's not you don't lick it off a stone. But when you find it, you'll know, and that's the important part. And we call upon our inner child, our little baby, like they say, baby Joe here, or whatever, young Joe, personally speaking, obviously. I call upon him every now and again, and yeah, I have a good time. So I ask y'all there. And to do the same thing for yourselves. And it is a personal journey, and it's a personal experience, and it's a beautiful thing. And do it. There you go. So now we're going to do some drumming. We're going to drum for about 10 minutes. And after that 10 minutes, I'm going to do a different rhythm. And that rhythm will be a callback. And your subconscious mind will know this. So, you know, whatever. Don't be, you know, get off the... I'll be thinking too much, you know what I mean? So yeah, and while we do that, I'm going to use the rattle in a minute. I'm going to warm my drum up first, get some resonance. So the rattle will connect us to the heavens, the drum will connect us to the earth, and we will be in between like a little child. So there you go. So for the crack, okay, just for the next 10 minutes, if you can, only suggesting this. Call upon your inner child. Have a little go. Bring them into the play. Bring them out to play. Okay? And I mean that. Play. Because isn't there enough stuff going on where you need to... You know, we know the reality of what's going on. I know that. So, I'm going to suggest that for this next drumming session, this next 10 minutes, we sit with our inner child. And we nurture our inner child, and we hold our inner child, and we let our inner child hold us. Okay, I think of, Right, I'm still here. I nearly said something. I thought I disappeared there. So anyway, we go back, and I say this again. We ask our inner child to hold us. And we will hold our inner child. Okay, so I'll see you in about 10 minutes. And thanks for joining in.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, welcome back. Oh, sorry, that I did it. I went off on a nice little wander. So here we are again, and we're going to now do some Reiki, some more Reiki, whatever. And this one will be for the frontline workers, from everyone to from. The cleaners to the bin collectors to the Gardaí, the army, the military, the army, the navy, the air corps, the nurses, like just I can't use the phrase it goes without saying, because they need to be mentioned all the time. And you know, there's other care, there's their healthcare assistants, there's the nurses, there's the doctors, there's the cleaners. There's all the people working in the care homes and the hospitals, obviously, and ourselves as well. Now, okay, we're not frontline workers in such a way that we're not in, you know, whatever. But I mean, we are doing what we need to do. That's the important part. So this is actually for us too. It'll go through us to them, to those who are on the ground at the coal face on the front line. And there are many, many, many people who do that. The people working in the shops, the people who they stack the shelves, they get the supplies in, they deliver the supplies, they provide the supplies. So the farmers, the farm workers, the many, many other people, like the till operators and stuff like that. So yeah, and if there's a few more, please mention them. If I've forgotten any, and I don't mean to forget any, just there's so many. So we need to acknowledge them, and I know we do, but I'm doing it again because I can. And there you are. So this next Reiki session is for them. So we're going to send out all the love and light to them, and to thank them for their work, and for their work that helps us do what we do. And yeah, so well done. Let's see, actually going to get a bit of a read here, see what Sister Stan has got to say. Just in relation to all of that. Now, the word God is mentioned here. I am a firm believer that if you care to choose a different word for the word God, please do. Source, universe, spirit, whatever. And that's okay too. But Sister Stan, she's a Christian, so she uses the word God because that is her God, and that's okay. But please do not use this as, please don't get offended by it. I'd still say the word here, of course. But my point in saying that is, this is not a religious broadcast. Spiritual, of course. And human, yes, of course. Religious, no. But I do love her work. I really do. And as a friend of mine said to me once, never let religion get in the way of you and your gods. I'm a big fan of a few people you'd be surprised about. And there you go. But that's cool. Anyway, hey Terry, how you doing? Hey Blaine. Anyway, so Sister Stan says, early in the morning, help me see all God's love, supporting, guiding, working in me, with me, through me. The music of gratitude is available all day, every day, when I remember to listen. Now, the music of source, the music of Mother Nature, the music of the rhythm of life, when I remember, this is the important thing. We need to remember who we are. We are going through a huge, huge change internally and externally. We need to remember where we've come from, where we are, and where we want to go. And all the way through that journey is us. As individuals, and collectively, of course, a collective of individuals. There you go. Would that be an oxymoron? I don't know. Maybe it is. Anyway, so with that, it's the inner light that guides us. It's our inner child. Now, we've spoken about that a few minutes ago. Our inner child that helps us find the way. And then, of course, the adults and or whatever that we are, and many other titles that we may carry, aunties and uncles, parents, mothers, fathers, we are brothers, we are sisters, we are nieces and we are nephews, we are sons and daughters, we are friends, and I don't think I've missed anything there. If I have, whatever, whatever. And so with this next Reiki session, we will send out the energy through us to the frontline workers. We will use that energy as well for us to guide us through our day, and we will just be ourselves. Okay, so I'm going to ask you again to join me, and I will ask you if you can to place your hands face up over, and then we're going to do two things. Okay, we're going to do this symbol here, which is the okay symbol. But if you close the fingers and put them down like this on your knees or your lap, whichever is comfortable, find a comfortable position. There's no rigidness in all this. And this is spirit over ego. Okay, there you go, and that's it. So I'm going to call up, I'm going to ask us to do that, or sit whatever way is comfortable for you. That's the important part, your comfort. And I'm going to call upon your higher selves. I'm going to call upon our ancestors and our inner child, and what else? Yeah, whoever you want, name a few for yourself. Hey Orla, how are you? Thanks for joining in. Name a few people for yourself who you want to join in, and so I see us in a few minutes, and with permission and respect, I call upon your higher selves to help in this healing for the others, to for the frontline workers. Okay, thanks. See you in a few minutes. Now, just bring ourselves back, and I ask that you put one hand over the other and let the light grow in your cupped, closed hands. When you feel that the light is brighter or the energy is stronger, bring your hands to your chest and let the light, let the energy go into you. And use that to feed your inner self, to feed your inner child, to feed your whole being. And use that to go about your day. And always remember to smile. Give yourself 15 seconds every now and again to raise your serotonin levels. And if you see a reflective surface or a mirror, blow yourself a kiss. All right, so now just let the rest of the energy go where it needs to go. Give yourself a little stretch in the arm. Wow. Oh, yeah. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. I'm going to play the bong thing 7 times just to close our chakras so we can ground ourselves. So. And let that there will close our chakras and ground us. And we shall go about our day. So thanks for joining in. It means a lot to me. And I appreciate your comments too, which is really nice. And if you're watching this on repeat, one, thank you for joining in. And two, the energies will work the same way. Possibly should have said that at the start, but I didn't. And here we are at the end saying that thing. So whatever. So go about your day, enjoy yourselves, do what you can, and be excellent to each other at a space minding distance, of course, and may your inner child brighten your day, and may you have a lovely day too. And again, thanks for joining in. So I love you, I love me, love and rock and roll. See you lads, have a good one, see you tomorrow. That's the plan, always the plan. So mind yourselves. Loads of love. Love you. I love me.